We are just a few days away from the official start of summer. It's a good time to get organized. So how do we keep our sanity as those summer plans heat up? Joining us to help make sense of it all is Karen Dahl, owner of Organizing Madison. Good to see you. This is a really stressful time for parents because their kids have more free time. They're trying to fill their plans with fun activities, and it's really easy to get overwhelmed. So what is the first rule as far as staying organized?
My first suggestion would be to write everything down on a calendar and just keep one calendar.
Uh-oh. Slap on my wrist. Yeah.
Well, a lot of people have paper calendar, which works fine. A lot of people have electronic calendars. Electronic calendars might be a better idea for people who have two parents or two caregivers taking care of the child to make sure that their calendars can be synced up and so that the kids get everywhere they need to go on time.
See, now I have one at here and then I have one at home. And it is a lot of work to make sure that they match up. It's easy to let something slip through the cracks.
It really is.
What about the parent who has a problem saying no? You know, the parent who wants their kids to be involved in everything. How do you manage that?
You really have to work to say no occasionally. I mean, I know it's great to expose your kids to a lot of different fun activities, but you also have to have some free time and some relaxing time and regrouping time in the summertime.
So. Is there a good system as far as putting, once you make a plan, what is the system to best keep everybody on the same page?
Well, like I said, keep a calendar, look at it often. I suggest looking at it at night and get your kids involved too. Have them take a look at the calendars because if they have five activities tomorrow, then they can lay out all their stuff that they need for activity. Designate a place for when you come in from all your activities in the house that they can dump all their stuff so that they make sure their jersey gets washed and their cleats are in the right place so you're not panicking like, Mom, I need my cleats for soccer practice.
And it's, oh no, where did we put them?
Right.
Neither one of us has kids, but you work with a lot of clients who have kids. What is the biggest challenge for families, you think, in dealing with the summer?
It's just the shuffling around, especially if you have multiple kids. It's a matter of making sure one gets here and one gets there and things happen on time. And it is really a challenge. And so it's really a matter of being organized, being consistent, and make sure you plan everything. Of course, plan some free time, but if something's not on the calendar, you're probably not going to get to it.
You also mentioned involving your kids. Is there an appropriate time when one of the kids is old enough to start to learn organization on their own?
I wouldn't say there's a specific age, but I think as kids grow, you can kind of test them out, make them responsible for just one thing at a time and start adding tasks. I think kids are, they can do a lot more than we think.
Yeah, and then it takes some of the burden off of you.
Absolutely.
So see, this is perfect. Yeah. It's just like chores.
Yes, and teaching them responsibility is always a good thing.
So one last piece of advice for parents as we let them go off and plan their summers.
Make sure you schedule some free time. Don't have every minute of the day scheduled, or you're never going to enjoy your summer. Madison has a lot of fun things to offer, so get out there and do some fun stuff with your family and friends, and maybe even some alone time. Be sure to schedule some time just to do some things just for yourself, too.
Right. That was my mom's famous word. You need more alone time. I'm still struggling with that one. But Karen, we appreciate your advice.
Thanks for having me.
Have a good summer.
Thank you.